Hi everyone, welcome to MindFit, brought to you by Home Care Assistance. I'm so excited to be bringing you our virtual edition of MindFit. If you live in San Diego, you might have joined me for one of our in-person classes in the last few years. And since we're all staying safe and healthy at home, we wanted to bring MindFit to you. And I hope you'll join us over the next few weeks for some great mind fitness. If you're new to MindFit or to Home Care Assistance, MindFit is one of our offerings through the Balanced Care Method, focusing on cognitive stimulation. Our mission at Home Care Assistance is to change the way the world ages, and we do that by focusing on five domains of healthy aging: cognitive stimulation, nutrition, physical activity, a sense of calm and purpose, and social engagement. And so today we're gonna dive into our cognitive stimulation domain by doing lots of different exercises, puzzles, and just things that get us thinking in new and different ways. We've got five exercises today: picture word search, quiz 100, what's that saying, and title challenge, as well as name that tune. Again, for many of these, there's no wrong answer. And the good news is just opening up this video and trying something different is getting your brain thinking in new and different ways. And that's a great way to keep your mind healthy. We're going to start with picture word search, and we're looking for words that begin with the letters B or S within this painting. It could be an action word, it could be an adjective, it could be an object that you see. For example, this baseball player is signing an autograph book, so that's an S. We've got a baseball over here. And I'm sure everyone's picking up a couple other objects or things within this painting that start with the letters B or S. So I'll give you a little bit of time to look for those. And I'll also point out at the bottom here, the artist that is responsible for this painting is John Philip Falter. And he's an American artist. He had 129 Saturday Evening Post covers in the 40s, 50s, 60s, all the way through the 70s. And I'll put up his website to the museum so you can check out those covers as well. So again, we're looking for words that begin with B or S. So far we've got baseball, this man is signing. You can look for articles of clothing. We've got socks over here and some shoes. Over here we've got a baseball bat. How about in the background here? There's something that starts with the letter B. If you've seen into a baseball dugout, you might see people sitting on this. This is the bench. So another good thing about picture word search is these paintings are a great way to spark conversation about different topics. And socializing and connecting with one another is another great way to keep your mind fit. So this painting makes me think about sports, and I'm wondering what sports everyone played. What was your first sport that you learned? Did you ever try a sport that you really didn't like? So it's a good topic to share on. Or you could talk about being a fan. Do you have a favorite sports team? Have you ever caught a ball when you were at a baseball game? So a little bit more than just the word search going on here. Okay, so the answers we came up with are up on the screen. A couple additional ones we didn't mention. Starstruck is bit more abstract. Shirt, belt, the baseball player is wearing a belt. Blue jeans in the back there. And let's see what else. The little girl has braids up there. Okay, next one is another picture word search. This is also a painting by John Philip Falter. And you'll notice both the pictures are look like scenes from spring. And just wanna send a word of encouragement to everybody that is staying close to home. Maybe you're not getting outside quite as much. We're all gonna get through this together, and just know that you know, if you need support or encouragement, feel free to reach out and connect with us here at Home Care Assistance and your care partners, your families. I know we're all working through this together. All right, so we've got picture word search. Find a word that begins with B or S. Again, we're doing the letters B or S. So I'll give you a little bit of time to look through. Words that begin with B or S. So they gave the example of boats in the background here. How about in the front? What do you see here? It looks like maybe some pigeons, so I'd say we've got birds there. How about a word to describe these two? They look like a couple. Maybe a word that starts with an S. I was thinking of sweethearts. And we've got some people here sitting on the edge of the fountain. They look like they might be taking in some sun, so we could say sunbathers. How about these two gentlemen here? Right there and right here. They look like they're in uniform, blue suit and a white hat. I'm thinking they might be sailors. All right, so here's our answers for this one. Boat, birds, boy, balloons. I missed the balloons there. Sailor, standing, skirt, sweethearts. Sunshine, sunbathing, sidewalk, sand, shade, and sharing. All right, we're gonna, we've got a website resource. This is the website that I mentioned. You can see all of John Falter's Saturday evening post covers if you go to this website. And they're great for, like I said, not just seeing the art, but sparking conversation about different topics. We're going to move on to our next exercise, which is quiz 100. And I'm going to pose some questions. You can come up with as many answers as you can. We'll put up the top five answers as when asked to a group of 100 people. And for example, name something that might break. Something that might break. The first thing that came to mind for me was, see if I can do a poor drawing here. So I was thinking of a window. It was something unpleasant, but most of us have gone through this at some point in life. We've got a heartbreak. And I'm not gonna attempt to draw the next one. I'm just gonna write it. This is always unpleasant when it happens. You might have a car that breaks down. So that's how this exercise works. We'll get started with our first question. Name something that comes in a pair. You can see each question has an example, a picture clue. So we're looking at some gloves here on the screen, which is a good hint. A few of the answers are articles of clothing. and we're looking for something that comes in a pair. All right, so we've got gloves, pants, dice, shoes, and scissors. All good answers. Next question, complete the following phrase. The three blank. Complete the following phrase, the three blank. And our picture clue is this very adorable piglet here. And one tip I didn't mention, if you want to take more time with each question, you can always pause the video before I move on to the answer slide, just to give yourself a little bit more time. And I will give another clue. Several of the answers are also other kinds of animals. So we've got the three little pigs is the clue, the picture clue. And there's a few other animals in the answers as well. So we've got the three musketeers, the three stooges, the three little pigs, the three bears, or I guess that's from Goldilocks and the Three Bears, and the three blind mice. All right, next question is name something people cut. Name something people cut. And our picture clue is a lawnmower. Looks like it's in the middle of cutting something. I'll give you another clue. There's something that people are not doing right now that you normally might do every month or every other month. Some people are trying to do this on their own for the first time or for other family members. And I've seen some pictures with mixed results on those attempts. There's something that people cut. And the answers that we came up with are grass. You might cut cake. Cut your hair. That's the one that people aren't doing these days. Cut your fingernails and, of course, cut a rug. I hope some of you are cutting a rug at home, getting some exercise and a good laugh, hopefully. We're going to do Name That Tune in a little bit so you can get ready to cut a rug. Name a public building that can be found in most cities. So this could be a government building or a location where the public would visit and get services. Our picture clue is a stack of books. So you can think about a building where you might go to get out some books. Some of these are places where you're wanting to spend time. Some of these are places that you're not wanting to spend a lot of time. All right, and our answers are library, courthouse, post office, school, and hospital. Next question, name a food you need to peel. So we've got some potatoes as our picture clue, and let's see, I guess the wording is a little inaccurate. You don't need to peel potatoes. I've eaten plenty of potato peels. So that might better read, name a food you sometimes peel. Name a food you sometimes peel. All right, our answers are potatoes, carrots, bananas, oranges, and onions. All right, we're going to move on to another exercise. We're just past halfway finished with our 30-minute mind fit today. I hope that you're having a good time so far and coming up with some creative answers. Our next exercise is called What's That Saying? So you want to make sure that you can see the screen. We're going to put up some picture clues on the screen, and they are hinting at or connected to a common phrase or idiom, so a saying that you might be familiar with. For example, and sometimes we'll give a starter to help you with a little bit of direction. These two pictures here, this pig and fly, are part of a phrase that starts with when blank blank. So the phrase that they're looking for is when pigs fly. All right, here's our next one. And we've got some kind of monkey here, several of them. Sometimes the answers have to do with the placement of the pictures. They have to do with a shape or placement on the screen. This is something that you would say if someone is joking or being playful. You might say this to children especially. The answer is monkeying around. If you're talking to kids, you might say quit monkeying around. All right, here's our next one. We've got two pictures here. It looks like a beach ball in the background there and a person's eye. And again, this might have something to do with the placement, the fact that the eye is in the center there. I'll give you one hint. This is something you might say in sports. Keep your eye on the ball. All right, next one. We've got two picture clues again. There's a light switch here and a nice wooden rocker. And this is something you might say to someone if they have a pretty wacky idea or doing something that doesn't quite make sense. You have to look closely at the light switch so you can see it has something to do with the position. This one is off your rocker. Off your rocker. All right. Okay, this one we've got a couple pictures. Again, this has something to do with the placement. And it looks like these are some metal whisk, something that you might have in your kitchen. And the center is just kind of a nondescript shrub or bush. This phrase you might say to someone if they are not getting to the point. Someone's not really getting to the point of an argument or comment. You might say you're blanking around the bush. You're to beat around the bush. Is this phrase? All right, now we're up to three pictures. And we're putting together what is the action that's taking place. And this one, we've got a little boy, it looks like, that's jumping rope. And I'll let you put together the rest of the clues. Oh, this one is to jump on the bandwagon. That one answer snuck up on me. To jump on the bandwagon. All right, we've got another one here. I wonder if anyone knows who this character is with the extended nose. His name starts with a P. If you guess Pinocchio, you're right. Looks like this character is from the Walt Disney film, but it was originally an Italian children's story. It was written back in 1883. So we've got Pinocchio and we've got some puppies that look like they're taking a nap. And this phrase starts with the word let. It is let blank, blank, blank. Something to do with what Pinocchio does a lot of. It gets him into trouble. Let sleeping dogs lie is the phrase. All right, if you get something 100% correct, the perfect answer, someone might say to you, this phrase. I'll give you a little bit of time to look at it here. Think about what he's doing with the bat and ball. The answer for this one is you hit the nail on the head. All right, so we're going to move on to our next exercise. This is called Title Challenge. And the following classic book titles, it could be children's or adults, have been shortened to just their initials with a few word clues. Can you come up with the original title? For example, T Great G. And it's good to remember some of the T's stand for the. So for this one, it is T Great G. And the answer is The Great Gatsby. All right, to K A M. To K A M. This is another mid-century. This is 1960s. 1960 to KAM. This one is To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. All right. S White 7D. What does that word and number puzzle connect to? S White 7D. This was adapted from an original Brothers Grimm story. If you guessed Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, you are correct. LUTS. 20,000 LUTS. This book was written by Jules Verne in 1870. 20,000 LUTS. It is 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. And that picture on the left is the original cover. This book is A Farewell TA. A Farewell TA. This was written by a very famous author in 1929. By the name of Ernest Hemingway. And the book is A Farewell to Arms. All right, we've got the C in the H. The C in the H. This book was written by an author, although he maintained a pen name, Theodore Geisel, in 1957. One is The Cat in the Hat by Dr. Seuss. Okay, TC in the R. TC in the R. This one's a little harder. This was written in 1951. The author's initials are JDS. TC in the Rye, if that helps anyone. It's The Catcher in the Rye. We've got a lot of books from the 1920s in this section. This is 1926, The S Also R. The S Also R. This book is by Ernest Hemingway. And it is The Sun Also Rises. All right, we're getting to our last exercise today. This one is Name That Tune. We will play the instrumental version of a popular song. And the goal is to try and determine the song title and the artist. So let's get started. If you guessed Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree by either the Andrews Sisters or the Glenn Miller Orchestra, you are correct. The song was first released by the Glenn Miller Orchestra in 1942, and it was later featured in the movie Private Buckaroo by the Andrews Sisters and the Harry James Orchestra. So let's enjoy a little bit of the Andrews Sisters performance. This song is Goodnight Irene, or Irene Goodnight. It's a 20th century American folk song, and it was first recorded by American blues musician Leadbelly in 1933, and it was later released as well by the group The Weavers in 1950. If you guessed You Belong to Me by Patti Page, you are correct. You would also be correct if you guessed Joni James, Joe Stafford, or Dean Martin. They all have versions of this song. It was originally sang by Joni James in 1952 and covered by many artists after that. So let's take a listen to the version by Patti Page. So that concludes all of our activities for our first virtual MindFit. I hope you enjoyed it. I did want to give one additional tip. As I mentioned earlier, in the Balanced Care Method, we focus on five different areas to promote healthy aging. One of them is cognitive stimulation for mental fitness, and another area is social engagement. And since we're not able to do this program face-to-face, I wanted to give a tip for social engagement that you might try this week. I know a lot of people are starting to use technology like video calls and other ways to stay connected during this time. Something I came across is sending a vintage photogram. I know we all send new photos that we've taken. There's a great application that you can use on your phone or a family member's phone called Photo Scan by Google, and you can scan in old photos without the glare or distortion, and send those out to a couple family members and start a conversation about your childhood or that crazy birthday party you had. So it's a good way to stay connected. And with that in mind, I also want to share with you a way to stay connected with me and with the MindFit program. My email address is here, mwile@homecareassistance.com. And the last resource I wanted to connect you to today is the Home Care Assistance Enrichment Guide. This has some great connections to virtual programming like museum tours, exercise classes, and lots of activity ideas as we're all staying at home. Again, feel free to reach out. I look forward to seeing you again soon. Hope you enjoyed the program.